What's something that's secretly been great about the pandemic? I have now learned that I don't lack time to do things. Just motivation. I have all the time in the world to get in shape and learn something new. A year later, and I've made much less progress than I should have given the amount of free time. I think this one is tricky. Don't be too hard on yourself. Despite it all, we are all going through a deeply traumatic global event, and may each encounter some level of PTSD after all this. Yes, I don't have any excuses to put my work off for later anymore. You lack discipline. Motivation is a lie. No one is motivated to go to work every day, to not miss any workouts, to eat properly. That can help you in the start, but you can't rely on it. I have a 19-year-old cat. Has been getting slower and I know what's on the horizon. But the fact that I've been able to be at home all day every day, has loved it, has on my lap hours a day, knowing that I've made his probably last year the best is probably the only thing good about the pandemic. Edit 1. Holy shit, this blew up in gold. Glad so many people can share their stories as well. FYI, even though he's 19, he's in good health, the vets are always surprised at his age and just has some arthritis in the hips. Edit 2. Cat tax. Taken this morning of said old boy. Good for you. M25 and the remaining 3/4 of the pets I had since grade school all had to be put down over the course of the last year. 2 dogs and a cat. They all just happened to be at that age, and I'm so glad I got to spend the last few months they had hanging out with them. My cat died of cancer this past summer. I'm glad I was able to be home with her for the last few months of her life. Same here. My girl isn't quite 19, she's just turned 14, but I've absolutely loved being able to play and have cuddles all day every day. My new fav thing to do is wake her up with treats in between my work. My employer now knows for sure that working from home is completely doable and really doesn't duck up productivity. I've also learned that I like going into the office once or twice a week just to break up the monotony of working from home all the time. I agree with both. I miss the social aspect of the office. Just me at home. So being cooped up so long is getting to me. Agree to the first part. Still don't miss the office at all though. Agreed, but once or twice a month will break up the monotony just fine for me. I haven't had a cold all year. Yeah, this past year has probably been the healthiest I've ever been. Haven't ever had anything more than a minor headache. And that's usually just due to dehydration or something mundane. My 14-year-old dog passed away last July. Our whole family had been working / schooling from home full-time starting in March, so we all got to love on her and care for her full-time for her last months. Same. My childhood dog passed away October 2020, had a stroke, and he suddenly couldn't walk or eat or drink. He was already skinnier due to his lack of appetite, so we decided to put him down. I think of him every day, and I think my other dog misses him too. Gave me the opening to get out of a dead-end delivery job and focus on the deuce I actually went to school for. Im, getting there, edit, holy smokes. This blew up. Thank you all for the kind words and awards. Any progress at all is still progress. No matter how insignificant it may seem. Edit, well, I went to sleep and this blew up massively. Thanks everyone for the awards and kind words. Without a social life, I've been forced to focus on myself instead of other people, so I've cut down on my drinking, lost 35 pounds, and started seeing a therapist. Here's hoping I come out of this in better physical and mental shape than I went in. Me too. I lost 17 pounds and I just was discharged from therapy because my depression is officially, clinically at a zero. Go us. Edit, holy crap. Thanks for the awards. Friends. To answer some questions, weight loss, I initially did a wellness challenge called 75 Hard, a 75-day challenge that requires 2 workouts per day, and sticking to a diet of your choice. Among several other daily tasks, that kicked my butt into gear, and got me into the habit of regularly exercising and eating well. So I've lost a few more lbs, since I completed it in September. This also helped my mental health a lot, but not completely. Mental health. I did acceptance and commitment therapy, which is a form of CBT that focuses on accepting your feelings and mindfully working through them. rather than avoiding them. My therapist had me fill out a questionnaire every time we met, and based on my answers, he was able to calculate numbers on a depression scale. I can't go into more detail about that, cause I don't know, but I started at a 4200ths and last week was at a 3 on 1 scale. And on another I started out at a 7/10ths and last week was at a 0. So I'm clinically not depressed, I guess. Plus, the last several weeks I've come to him feeling great and having little to talk about, which meant it was time for me to be discharged. Why was I discharged? My therapist works out of a medical facility rather than private practice. So they go based on a medical model. It's more of a let's give our patients the tools they need to cope, and once they no longer need us, well, let them go so they can make room for more patients with acute needs. Rather than a well see patients, as long as they pay us. I cold been referred to someone like that. But, like I said, I didn't have much to talk about by the end. What specifically helped me? Mindfulness exercises and writing down 5 good things about myself each day. My negative self-talk was the biggest factor in my depression. I don't do that anymore. I'm a badass. A lot of restaurants have really upped their online ordering and drive-through game. Like a well-oiled machine. And some shockingly haven't. I got takeout from one of my favorite restaurants the other day, and it took so long to order on the phone that next time I'm just going to go down there and place an order in person. I had to speak to 3 different people to accomplish it, being put on hold each time, and give my credit card over the phone. And before you ask, yes, they advertise takeout on their website and menu. So it isn't as if it's a service they don't normally provide. Save money on gas. Not to mention wasting time just sitting in a traffic jam to get to a desk that I also happen to have in the office at home. If it wasn't for the pandemic, my dad would be dead right now. He likes to come over to our place while I'm at work and spend time with my dogs. My Papillon got away from him and wanted to play chase in our garage, which is basically a storage unit right now. And she was bobbing and weaving through boxes when he caught her and took her inside. He noticed he was having a hard time catching his breath. My brother, who lives with me, offered to let him use his new oxygen meter, which he bought after he developed some temporary sleep apnea after he had COVID. The meter was frighteningly low, so he told our dad to go to the walk-in clinic. They told him, as soon as he explained his oxygen level, that he needed to go to the ER. He tests negative for COVID at the ER, but they found multiple blood clots in his lungs. They kept him a few days in the hospital, and he made a complete recovery with no permanent damage. I know my dad very well. Under normal circumstances, he would have gone home, tried to relax, gone to bed that night, and possibly never woken up the next morning. But COVID has us all on high alert, especially when it comes to breathing troubles. I never thought he'd be thankful for it also. After he got out of the hospital, he gave said Papillon an extra special doggy treat for saving his life. That's such a sweet story, made all the better by your Papillon. Fear the bestest. Not dealing with a commute. I got 6 to 8 hours a week back in commuting time. That's like about a whole extra work day every week that's mine to do with as I please. It's been incredible. And I hadn't realized how stressed my commute makes me. I don't have to be careful not to forget anything before I leave for work, or when I'm leaving the office at the end of the day. I don't have to pack lunch. I don't have to make sure I'm dressed for the weather both now and in 8 hours when I'm coming home. I don't have to get wet when I get that wrong. And I don't have to spend a day at work with my shoes and socks wet, or all of me wet. I don't have to wait at a bus stop for 40 minutes waiting for a bus that should have been here 30 minutes ago. No commute, well, no commute, no commute people, no delayed trains, no weather. Less health issues, even just less colds from constant changing temps, time morning, 2 hours extra sleep, and not having to get ready day. Generally chores, laundry, cleaning, dishes get done on work downtime. So this frees time on the weekends afternoon, 1.5 hours of me time. Money communing total costs for my household, just for work, was around $500 a month. The added cost of heating / cooling, electricity, etc. from being home is nowhere near that. Food, I can cook all my own food, don't need to replace going to work stuff. Clothes, shoes, beauty products, ETC health I can work out more regularly, get sleep, eat better. And X200B, also getting stuck at work by 5 minutes. No longer means getting a train 30 minutes later, it actually means 5 minutes. I'm sick a lot less often. The kids are doing school entirely from home, so they don't bring crap home like they used to. This has definitely been my healthiest winter ever. I don't have kids, but I also got sick 0 times last year. Amazing what never leaving home and wearing masks will do. COVID aside, went from taking a week of sick time off over all of 2019 to no days off, except holidays in 2020. I saw a news story a few weeks ago about how cases of the normal flu were slashed by masking and social distancing. I get this horrible cough every winter. It's weeks. Sometimes an entire month of very literally non-stop coughing where I can barely sleep or breathe. This was the first year I didn't have it. Spending time with my dog. Dogs are the real winners of the pandemic. My dog is getting up there, and I'm so grateful that I've been able to spend extra time with him. I lost two of mine a month ago. This last year gave me a lot of time with them, and I'm grateful for it. Give your pupper some scritches for me. No pressure to go somewhere on my days off. I don't feel like I'm wasting time when I have days off and don't spend them traveling or seeing people. I love staying at home and just hanging with my two cats. Sweatpants on. Messy bun. Junk food and games. I'm content with that. Yes. I think I have learned to accept my homebody nature instead of feeling like I should be going out and doing things. There's nothing wrong with making a home for yourself and then enjoying being there. My wife used to pressure me nearly every weekend to go do something outside the house. It's really nice to be able to relax at home. Now, reliably. Edit, litter. Saved a lot of money not going out or traveling. Don't get me wrong. I'm not happy about it, and far rather would have spent it. But I do have more money. Even just not commuting saves a ton of money. I was paying 15 bucks a day on light rail and parking at the station, and then buying crappy expensive lunch and coffee near the office. Now, I work at home, where I eat my own food and drink my own coffee. I'm probably saving at least 150 a week. There's a travel explosion coming from the pent-up demand right after this thing is over. Isn't there? I now permanently work from home, which is amazing. Me prior to 2020, man, getting a job working from home would be amazing. But I don't even know where to start. Me getting moved to permanently work from home due to COVID. Oh, okay, well that works, I guess. Finding out that not everyone needs to trudge for over an hour or more to get their job 5 days a week. That it's possible to work from home perfectly fine. Edit, yes. I know not everyone can work from home. Some people have to go in. This is why I specifically stated not everyone. Also, thanks for the awards. See? Commuting should get way better even for people who don't stay permanent WFH. If a large number of companies switch to that, the road should become way less congested, and people who commute will probably spend much less time stuck in traffic. Contactless delivery. Oh yeah, just drop it on the porch. My man, I've been obsessively watching your progress, so I'll get it immediately after you leave. We don't need to chat. This better stick around after the pandemic. I've doubled what I tip, in part because deuce is tough right now, but also because I love not having to answer the door to meet someone when I'm high off and just want my food. Leave a door. I'm missing a tooth fairly close to the front of my mouth, and I don't feel self-conscious smiling in public when I'm wearing a mask. It's a silly thing, but I kinda missed real smiles. Thanks for the awards. Guys, my most liked slash commented comment is about my trucked up teeth. That's something. Lol. I read missing a tooth fairy too. Same. I feel you. Almost all of my teeth are trashed from my various illnesses. I can't afford to fix my teeth, and a mask makes me feel so much better. Sleep. Yeah. I should get up and do some work now. Yes. No alarm clocks. Playing board games with my teenage kids. We got away from it as they got older. I still kick ass on Scrabble, but they smoke me on backgammon. Ticket to Ride is a blast. Yahtzee too. I have two teens and a spouse. We really enjoy spoons and bullpup. Easy. fast-paced card games. We also play blackjack as a family. We have a whole set of cards and chips. We keep a running tally of our chips on paper. My husband gets so mad because our daughter plays her gut and he plays by the rules, and she is like a fake billionaire now and has always panhandling for fake money to get him back in the game. It's a riot. Our son is always the dealer. Our casino is named after him, and it's a good exercise in social skills and self-control. Getting to home cook meals while at work is a fantastic weight loss plan. Down almost 50 pounds since September and haven't looked back. Edit, this comment blew up. Thanks for the awards, but if you are looking for ways to spend money, please donate to your favorite quality charity instead of buying me virtual stickers. As far as how I've done it, I don't want to shill for anyone, but I've been using Noom since September, which has basically helped me manage my sicko calories in slash calories out with a fine tooth comb, and also helped adjust my mental approach to health and specifically how I look at food. I spend most of my time in the grocery store in the produce aisle now. I don't try to necessarily view foods as good and bad, but instead look at different foods and how they will help me. And I don't sit and stress over any bumps in the road. Weight gains are just things my body needs from time to time to help on the journey. And sometimes you just need a treat for mental joy, which is okay. I'd be happy to offer advice to anyone who wants it. But also know that I'm still learning new things every day about my own weight loss journey. Worked opposite for us. More time to cook means we're all eating more. I've gained 14 pounds in a year, which is really not good as I'm short af. But on the other hand, the whole family are happier. I can mouth obscenities at people and they don't have a clue. This is my absolute favorite thing. And if I double up on the masks, I can mumble under my breath and they don't hear it. Soft-spoken people happiness. Lol. Cleaner beaches and ocean in Hawaii as millions of tourists stayed home. Of course the economy went to SHT, but the Aloha Arena prospered. And way less traffic on the morning commute on the H1. Having a mask on in the cold is low-key the best. Agreed. I will be wearing a mask every winter season from here on out. For warmth and to protect against germs. Unless you have glasses, edit, y'all. I've tried wearing my mask slash glasses all kinds of ways and short of hermetically sealing the mask against my skin, it's still gonna fog up in the cold no matter what. Haven't tried the anti-fog stuff though, so I may check that out. Not seeing your toxic coworkers. Cries in hospital worker. The toxic ones became more insufferable, since they are some of the only people I see now. My caution and anxiety about people can be successfully hidden by the pandemic. I'm not forced to be overly social and can more successfully avoid crowded areas. I'm worried my mild agoraphobia before the pandemic is going to be a bit more severe after this is all over. Same. This has been the best year for my mental health that I can remember. For me personally, online learning. It just clicks with my brain somehow. I've gotten the best grades these past few semesters of my whole time in college. I'm off academic probation. I got an A in a class I failed twice before acquired for my major. And I'm able to do a second major I really wanted. I'm so much less stressed about exams. And it feels so good to be able to show my parents grades I'm proud of. I don't know how I would have been able to do this without online classes. I had a lot of trouble with attendance and my bad memory, and now I'm able to go to class from my room and rewatch lectures and have some notes for exams. I felt so low my first few years of college, and I finally feel good about myself as a student. It's still hard to believe that it's me getting these grades, and graduation is scary, but I'm so glad I get to do it. Edit, thank you so much for all of the support and the really interesting discussions people are having, and a special thank you to the people who gave me awards. That's very kind of you all. I think the big takeaway here is that neither online nor in-person classes are objectively better, and that different learning formats work for different people. Hopefully colleges will be able to offer all or most classes in either format post-pandemic, so that students can choose which version works for them. Good luck everyone. I believe in you. Sadly the opposite for me. I used to be a straight A student, and I'm now occasionally dipping into a few D's while okay. Thank you for the upvotes. I feel so popular lol. Sorry to see other people are in the same or similar situations as myself. Distractions are the main issue, and dealing with them can be nearly impossible. If you have never had an actual use for your phone during class, such as taking photos or texting a friend to ask for help, then you can probably leave it out of the room. Or as a compromise, try to be on your phone only in between classes. It helped me a little. Maybe setting up a loose schedule would help as well, so there are some boundaries you are more willing to follow, but are flexible enough that you will actually continue to use them. For example, 30 minutes of screen time during lunch, then homework for a few hours. If you finish homework early, do future homework. If there is no future homework, start learning a language. If you don't want to learn a language, then do chores. Use that designated time to get boring helpful things out of the way, then blow the rest on mindless entertainment and dinner. Hopefully that helps some people. I have a 14-month-old daughter, born in January 2020. Had I been commuting to work every day, I would have missed out on a lot of her early months of development and won't have the bond with her that I do. Also use the time to teach my 4-year-old son to ride a bike, and went on some awesome bike rides with him. We were locked to a 5-kilometer radius for a while, and we got to know our neighborhood really well. Made rafts and floated them down the creek. Harassed a lot of bull ants, and jumped in a lot of puddles. Dude, same. My baby is about to make a year. March 2020. The fact that I can stay home and be with him for the first year while keeping my job is a dream come true. 100% agree. My son was born in February and I've spent so much time with him I wouldn't have had otherwise. No commute, extra half hour on either side of the workday plus lunch breaks. If my bosses think I'm coming back to the office after this, they can eat 10,000 dicks instead. I can get another job, but I can't get back this time as a dad. My wife loves the pandemic because she gets to work from home. So no more commuting to work. She has basically gotten back 2 hours of her day. Nice. Lucky for her, office work from home is much more practical and financially better. People finally washing their hands. I haven't been told it looked prettier if I smiled in like a year. It's kinda awesome. One of the first days after reopening, I had a guy tell me us all wearing masks was rude because he couldn't tell if we were smiling. I got furloughed from a store position in March. Got on unemployment. Got paid to play video games until July, and just as my unemployment was set to run out, I came back on in an office position from my couch, working less hours for the same pay. Somehow I've come out on top of all this. My savings have skyrocketed, and I don't have to see people anymore. Win freaking win. I know with all the people struggling financially that it's not polite to say, but the pandemic has really been very helpful for our family financially. Easily put 10,000 into savings because of it. My wife's work was temporarily closed from March to September, but she was still getting her normal pay, and she stayed home with our kids, so no daycare costs. Im and NZ so super lucky. When it first hit, we locked down for 4 weeks. Im self-employed, so the government gave me a wage subsidy, like 30% of my normal income, but plenty to live on. Best bit is I was renovating my house at the time. So I got paid to renovate my own place for 4 weeks. 4 weeks, cries in American. Oh man. I'm so jealous at the way your community handled the whole thing. I'm glad it's gone well for you. No company holiday parties. My company, instead of springing for the annual holiday party and summer picnic and other social nonsense, has delivered us monthly care packages. So far we've had an oatmeal box, gourmet toppings and go withs, plus a pack of local steel cut oats, a hot sauce box full of brands I'd never heard of, a charcuterie box, some assembly required, a grilled cheese box, included a grill pan even, and a tabletop s'mores box. Another other fun things. Our team Slack has a channel devoted to the discussion about the monthly boxes slash baskets. Let me tell you. I mucking love not having to fake smile at everyone all the time. Not shaking hands. I have palmar hyperhidrosis, sweaty palms, and I'm always nervous about shaking hands. I try to manage it, but it is always a stressor. No more. I got to spend a lot more time with aging pets. I had to put down a cat this fall, but for 7 months he got to lay on my keyboard and interrupt Zoom calls all day. I also have a 12-year-old lab, and spending this year with her all day every day has been awesome. people have been able to spend more quality time with their children and pets. I live in New York City. Gotta admit one thing I like about the masks. I love walking around and listening to my music while lip-syncing hardcore without people noticing LMAO. My neighbor and I started spending every day together. After 6 months of lockdown, I joked that she should move in with me. A couple months later she did. A few months later we kissed for the first time and it's been amazing ever since. My daughter is medically fragile, and we pulled her out of her school when COVID hit. She's only 3 1/2. She's developmentally delayed and went to a special preschool. I was able to drop down at work and we've really been working with her. My kids get to see me more, and my daughter is making wonderful improvement. She's rarely been sick this past year. It's been her healthiest year. Working from home. I love not having to communicate with anyone face to face, because I stutter too much. I lost my husband before the pandemic hit. My daughter was daddy's little girl. This whole year has been us bonding again. She's 5. Her whole life has been hard. I'm disabled. We were homeless. My son, who has a different father, didn't allow him to be in the shelter with us. This is the first time in her life where I'm not hospitalized. We have a stable roof over our heads and have time for each other after all the absolute chaos of the first 4 years of her life. Also, my son was with me for 6 full months without having to go back to his dad's. Honestly, for my family, it was a blessing in disguise. I got a fully funded scholarship and met Jane Michelle Basquiat's studio assistant while working on a paper about him. I have a daughter. She's 2 now, and I used to work at Taco Bell as a manager, and would get off work around 4/5 in the morning. Barely had any time for myself, let alone school. When the pandemic happened, some of her father's family members became home more. We lived with them, and I was able to start and finish a medical office administration program, and now I'm certified working as a medical billing assistant 9 to 5, and my graduation is in April. M24 FBTW.